सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रीहरिप्राणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतं वन्दे भगवन्तं पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ हुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः ब्रह्माण यदापूर्व यदागच्च प्रणोत तस्मै तदुंह देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घन गणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिर्बोध्यं बुद्धिर्पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं नमत्वमिति मे निश्चिता मतिः Let's give it a last push to finish the rest of Vichara Sagara. So 519th avarta begins with Tarkadrishti's Upadesha to his father Shubhasantati. He is the only son who is roaming around now, or he is the only one who is present now for the father. He just appeared when his father, the emperor, was facing the issue of who should be Upasya. He has less vairagya, so he couldn't leave the kingdoms, and thereby the Pandita Sabha has left him more confused. There is a we have not seen this. So the Tippana earlier, when these pramanas were mentioned, there is Sankhya has been said to be Nireshwara. So Nireshwara Sankhya Mate, and the reference has been given in which Tika and which Avarta it is covered. So then in the same textbook here, Pratyaksha Manumanam Shabda and Upamana, then Pratyaksha Anumana. This is as per the Vaisheshika. And so you see here, Vaisheshika Nyayamate Chattvari Pramanani, Vaisheshika Mate Trini Pramana, Dve Pramana. So the third reference has been given here in the Tippana. So the four Pramanas for Nyaya, Nayayikas, are Pratyaksha Anumana Shabda and Upamana, whereas for Vaisheshika it is only Pratyaksha and Anumana. Then there is a Tippana, it's a story I just mentioned. So इतोपि अपूर्वः संशयः समजनि सो ईदृश विरुद्धवाद श्रवणेन द विरोध हैज बीन शोन हियर इन मताज देमसेल्व्स बट देन द पंडितास हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट उपासना व्हिच देवता इज उपास्य देयर द पंडितास हैव गिवन कंफ्यूजिंग व्यूज सो द राजा हु वाज कंफ्यूज्ड हैज बिकम मोर कंफ्यूज्ड नाउ सो फॉर दैट देयर इज अ स्टोरी गिवन एज टू व्हाट इज हिज लॉट कस्यचिद् वृद्धस्त्रियः गृहाद् वारी कश्चन गृहद्वारी कश्चन मार्जारो मृतो भूत सो देयर वाज अ कैट डेड इन फ्रंट ऑफ अ वुमन्स हाउस सो द वुमन इज हैज यू नो कम आउट इन द मॉर्निंग एंड शी लुक्स एट देयर इज अ डेड कैट इन फ्रंट ऑफ हर हाउस सा तम ग्रामाद् बहिर् निसार्य यावत् प्रत्यागता तावत् प्राग् द्वारी रुग्णः कश्चित् उष्ट्रो मृतो भूत So she went outside the village to throw away the cat, dispose of the cat, dead cat. And when she comes back, she looks at it, that in front of her door, there is a camel who is deceased, an old or a deceased camel. That camel is dead. So it start to take care of a small problem. And since you aren't there, the camel has just wander about in front of your house and drop dead there. How do you take care of the camel now? So this is the case of the king. He went to take care of his doubt, ended up with more number of doubts. So yatha asya yatha asyaha chintayaha चिंतानंतरम महद महद उदभूत उदभूत डज नॉट सीम टू राइट बट महद उत्तभूत सो या उत्तभूत सो उदभूत उत इज एन उपसर्ग देर सो हाउ अ लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स केम टू द फोरफ्रंट सिमिलरली इज द तथा शुभ संततेः अपि उपास्य देवता विषयक अज्ञान निवृत्ते पंडितान पृष्टवतः संशयांतरम एव नवम अभूत सो न्यू डाउट्स केम अबाउट नाउ तन्निवृत्त्यर्थं तस्य महती चिंता अपि अभवत सो ही हैड लॉट ऑफ चिंता अबाउट व्हाट टू डू अबाउट दिस इश्यू नाउ सो दैट टाइम तर्क दृष्टि अपीयर्ड सो तर्क दृष्टि कृतः पितृ उपदेशः कारण स्वरूप उपास्यम न कार्य स्वरूपम सो कारण कार्य संबंध इज देयर बिटवीन ब्रह्म एंड द प्रपंच कारण इज रियली ईश्वर एंड सिंस ईश्वर इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम निर्गुण ब्रह्म सगुण इज नेवर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम निर्गुण सो निर्गुण इज उपास्य हाउएवर उपासन ऑफ निर्गुण इज नॉट ईजी देयरफॉर व्हाट तर्क दृष्टि मीन्स इज दैट कार्य बिगिनिंग विद हिरण्यगर्भ हिरण्यगर्भ एंड एनीथिंग दैट फॉलोज दैट इज कार्य कॉल्ड एज कार्य ब्रह्म इज नॉट उपास्य एट ऑल बट नॉट उपास्य एट ऑल मीन्स नॉट फॉर मोक्ष सो हु इज उपास्य द कारण ब्रह्म मीनिंग ईश्वर इन एनी फॉर्म ईश्वर हैज अ फॉर्म सगुण Therefore, all these people who have talked about this devata is upasya, that devata is upasya, in the form of the devata, they are not really upasya. In the form of the devata, it's limited to only that particular role. Limited to a particular karya role, assigned as, you know, let's say Brahma as a creator, Vishnu as a sustainer, and Shiva as a destroyer or who resolves the prapancha. If that is a limited aspect with which you do upasana, then they are not upasya, they are karya brahma. Hiranyagarbha upasana, karya brahma upasana. If someone says Ganapati or Devi is upasya, yes, but not in that limited role, only vigna harta. Not just as a vigna harta, but Ganesha is upasya as Ishvara himself. Then that form is of the Karana Brahma, not of Karya Brahma. So you say every thing in this prapancha has come about from Ganesha. He is the creator. Then you know that it is Karana, not the Karya. He does not have a limited role. Similarly, Devi Upasana. Devi is the Karana. So you look at any core text which deals with not a Katha, not a Purana Katha, but you look at the core, even in the Puranas, if you look at the core text behind that, not just a limited single story or a hand-picked number of stories, but if you look at the overall view of the Puranas also, dealing with each of these devatas, based on, you know, the Puranas named on those devatas, then those very devatas are projected as Karana of the Prapancha. So that is Ishvara. Lalita Sahasranama, you look at it, there also you will see that Devi is Upasya in the form of Ishwari. So that is the Upasya Devata, not any other. So na Karya Swarupam. So with this background, now we can see, he takes up all cases and says that, what is this Karana Brahma? Pitush Chinta Krantatam Drushtva Tata. भवत् चित्तस्य कुतो व्याकुलता इति तर्कदृष्टि पितरं पप्रच्छ सो यास लुकिंग एट दिस चिंता विच इज सीन ऑन हिज फेस सो तर्कदृष्टि आस हिज फादर व्हाट इज बॉदरिंग यू शुभ संतति द फादर रिप्लाइड स्वपुत्रोक्तं श्रुत्वा स्वचिंता कारणीभूतं विशिष्टं वृत्तांतं अकथयत सो ही नरेटेड ऑल दैट हैपेंड किम एकं उपास्यं दैवतम् इति पप्रच्छ च देन ही आस्क्ड सो दिस किम can have two interpretations. Kim, ekam upasyam daivatam. Whether one devata is upasya or many devatas are upasya, that is one interpretation, and whether devata is upasya at all. Is there one at all? So, is there such a devata is upasya, or is there only one to be upasya, or all? These kind of interpretations can be made, and you see the answer is tarkadrishtif pitruvachanam shrutva tasya shubodayartham ah. For the benefit of the father, tarkadrishti answered karana swarupam eva upasyam na karya swarupam karana swarupasya namani anantani ayam eva cha vedasya mukhya siddhantah. So karana swarupa is upasya, karya is not upasya, but karana itself, not karya. Karya is manifold, but karana itself is known through, karana brahma is known through many names. Just because the names are different does not mean that they are karya. They can be karana also. They can be karya as well. It will come up as, based on the context, the deity can be dealt with as karana also, karya also. So you have to look at the context in which the devata is being talked about. If it is talked about as karya contextually, then that form of that very deity is not upasya. For moksha, for the upasana will not lead to moksha, of course, but this moksha is in jivan mukti, but it will lead to moksha as krama mukti, where jnanena moksha is held, but then krama mukti is there. One reaches brahmaloka, and in brahmaloka one gets the jnana, which is very easy to attain. Going to brahmaloka is extremely difficult. So this upasana that Shubha Santati is looking for is not for Jivan Mukti. He wants to know which devata will take care of me. Take care of me now and hereafter through and through, so that I reach the Purushartha. So that this is the Mukhya Siddhanta. Ayam eva cha Vedasya Mukhya Siddhanta. Itihasa Puranadishu api Ayam eva Siddhanta Bhagavata Vedavyasena Nirupitaha na anyaha. So Vedavyasa has also said this same thing in various Puranas, not in one. In all Puranas, the same thing has been described. Panditaha tu imam avipraayam ajanantaha. These panditas are scholars, they are research scholars, or they are committed to their ishtadevatas, not beyond that. They don't have the bird's eye view of the Shastras. Although they are panditas, they are specialized in their own fields. If they have moksha ichha, then they'll see the tatparya. They don't have tatparya nishchaya, because they are committed either in their own sampradayas, their own upbringings, limited to focus on a particular deity, or due to ishtadevata, choice of ishtadevata, they are focused on a single deity, and due to dvesha for others, they have dvesha for other deities also, other people also. So they don't have samanvaya at all. Meaning, imam abhipraya ajanantaha panditaha. They are unaware of this idea, what is the mukhya siddhanta of Vedas. Therefore, parasparam matantaram khandayanti. They do khandan of other matas without knowing that the same karana brahma exists in their puranas also as in the other puranas. Shri Neelakanta panditenapi भारत व्याख्यान आरंभे प्रसंगादयमर्थ निरूपितः. सो इन महाभारत व्याख्यान श्री नीलकंठ पंडिता हु हैड तात्पर्य निश्चय, ही हैज शोन दिस वेरी आइडिया इन द इंट्रोडक्शन बेस्ड ऑन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट. तत्र एव उत्तमः श्रुति सिद्धांत अपि यथावत निरूपितः, एंड दिस श्रुति सिद्धांत इज डिस्कस देयर एज वेल. पुराणेषु श्रूयमाणयोः स्तुति निंदयोः व्यासाभिप्रायः. देन व्हाई डिड व्यासाचार्य, हु क्रिएटेड दीज 18 पुराणास एंड उपपुराणास, सम ऑफ दीज उपपुराणास, व्हाई वुड ही शो दैट वन डीटी इज सुपीरियर टू द अदर इन द रिस्पेक्टिव पुराणास, देयर ओन पुराणास. Why would he show one as superior to the other? Why would he do ninda of the others in each of these Puranas? So in Shiva Purana, Shiva is shown to be superior and Vishnu is Nindita, so to say, and others are Nindita. If you look at Vishnu Purana Ityadi, then Vishnu is praised. He is the Uttama Devata, he is the Karana Brahma, and others are Shiva Ityadi Devatas are Nindita. Why would he do that? There is a Virodha. So there are two options now. Either there is a Virodha, contradiction, which means what? It means that something is wrong. I mean, you can't trust the source if there is real Virodha. Which means that you cannot go ahead and follow what has been said, because it is confusing. Somebody has to remove this confusion, this contradiction. Is it real or is it apparent? Which is the same story in Upanishads also. On the other hand, flip side, if you say, okay, then the focus is not towards this upasana per se, meaning there is ninda of the other. That is the Tatpari Vishya. The other should not be followed. So Vishnu Purana says Shiva is not Upasya, Shiva Purana says Vishnu is not Upasya, that is the Tatpariya there. If that is the understanding which we follow or which we hold on to, then what will happen? We take each and every Purana and see that there is Khandana done of other deities. So if you, in sum total, if you look at the Tatpurya of all Puranas and see that it is Ninda, then all Upasanas will be Nindita. If all Upasanas are Nindita, there is no Upasana to do. So that is the topic here. Nanu, Sarva Purana Karta Shri Vedavyasa Eka Eva Sahi Skanda Purane Shivasya Swatantryad Ishwara Dharma Swatantryad Ishwara Dharma Santi Iti Pratipadayamasa. In Skanda Purana, Bhagavan Vyasa has shown that there is Swatantra of Shiva, he is independent, and thereby he is Ishwara. The Ishwara Dharmas have been shown. Devatanantaranyancha Shiva Krupaya Eva Sarva Vibhuta Yatishayaha Jayata Iticha. And he has shown that every Vibhuti seen in each and every deity is all due to Shiva. It is Shiva's Mahima, which is what you see in, now if you follow Gita also, you see Yadyat Vibhuti Mat. That should be known as Madamshena. Madamsha. Krishna says that it is my Amsha wherever you see Vibhuti. So it is the case everywhere. Each deity is discussed in that very manner. Tatha Tenaiva Vishnu Purane Padma Purana Adaucha Vishnu Rishwaratvam Uktam. So Vishnu is shown as Ishwara in Vishnu Purana and Padma Purana. Padma Purana. So, ittham eva puraneshu upapuraneshu cha Shiva Vishnu bhinna Ganeshadi devanam api ishwaratvam pratipadyate. If you go to Ganeshadi, devatas being discussed in other Puranas also, upapuranas and Puranas, you see, every deity is talked about as Ishwara. Tadevam vyasavachasam paraspara virodha upalabhyate iti. Thereby, there is contradiction across Puranas created by the same author. Atra Abhidhiyate, what is the idea there? Sarve api Ishwaraiva. Sarve, all of these are Ishwara. How so? There are not multiple Ishwaras. They are the forms of the same Ishwara. Sarva Shabdena, Vishnu Shiva Ganesha Devi Suryadayo Griyante. Vishnu Shiva Ganesha Devi Surya, all these and many others are included in Sarva Shabda. So all these are Ishwaras. Not Ishwaras, Ishwaraha, but Ishwaraha. Plural to land in one Ishwara. Ishwaratvam is there in all these when you look at them as Karana. Yatrasya devasya upasyatva pratipadana tatpuryena tad itara devata ninda shruyate tatra tannindayaha tad upasana parityage na tatpuryam. There is no tatpurya in the ninda of the others really. So, nahi ninda nyaya. Others are nindita to say that what is nindita you do not follow. Meaning what? In Shiva Purana or Skanda Purana, when Shiva is praised as Ishwara, then and others are shown in limited roles, then in those limited roles, they are not upasya. Shiva is upasya. Why? Because he is Ishvara. As Ishvara, Shiva is upasya. If you go to Vishnu Purana, Padma Purana, then what do you see there? There you see that Vishnu is Ishvara. Shiva is a devotee. As a devotee, he is not upasya. So if you do Shiva upasana, you do as Shiva as Ishvara. You follow the upasya devata as Ishvara. That should be the vritti. It should not be some katha saying that, oh, Shiva did this, he killed someone or whatever. All that is not to be in your upasana. Your vritti should be Shiva is the source of this entire prapancha. He is in the form of this entire prapancha manifest. That is Shiva. Shubham, you know that Shubha, Shiva, auspicious, that is only Brahma, Karana Brahma. Advaitam. Similarly, in Vishnu Purana, when Vishnu is praised as Ishvara, that is the form of Vishnu which is Upasya, not the form of Vishnu which is discussed in Shiva Purana. Similarly with the other Puranas, that is the Tatparya, not Ninda. Ninda is not the Tatparya there. So, Parityaga Upasana of other deities is not the Tatparya. Kintu Prakarani Kintu Prakarani Stutya, Prakarana Stutya maybe, in Prakarana, what is this? Stuti done there, Tad Upasanayam Eva. So there is this, the Tatparya. Tatparyam is Tad Upasanayam Eva. Is only in the Upasana of that particular deity as Ishvara. Yatha Vishnu Puraneshu Shivadi Devata Ninda. Vishnu Stuti Dvara Tadupasana Pravrutta Veva Hetuhu Evam Shiva Purana Adishu Krita Vishnu Adi Ninda Api Shiva Stuti Dvara Tadupasana Pravrutta Veva Hetuhu. So the Hetu in each of these Puranas is to see that particular deity as Ishvara, not the Upasana of others being Nindita. Meaning, those deities are not upasya. That is not the tatparya. The deities are not upasya in the form of a subsidiary to the or devotees or any other way discussed in particular Puranas, but only Puranas or Upapuranas, but only as Ishvara. Ekatra krita devatantara ninda tad devatanantara upasana parityagartha yadi syat. Had the Puranas had commitment in ninda of the others and thereby saying that others are not upasya, then you sum total with what? No devata is upasya. Sarva devata upasana parityaga prasanga eva syat. Tasmad anya devata ninda anyasya kasya chit upasasya stutaye natu tad upasana parityagaya. So it is not, no Purana is committed to do ninda in the others to, or by doing ninda, no Purana or Upapurana is committed to say that the others are not upasya, meaning upasana parityaga is not the tatparivishya, but that deity whose stuti is being done, who is praised, that deity is upasya as Ishvara. So that is the sum total there, that's the idea. Atra drashtanta, it is not needed, but then sadhu has preferred to do spoon feeding here. So he says there is a drashtanta here. For Vaidikas, it is very easy to see through drashtanta. So what is being said here? Vede agnihotrasya do kala uktau. Eka suryodayat prak dvitiya udayat anantaraha. Udite juhoti anudite juhoti iti. So this is very famous that udite juhoti anudite juhoti. So those who have studied Vyakrana, for them, or even Sanskrita, Sati Saptami, for that, this example is very, very common. Udite juhoti, anudite juhoti. So this Homa, which has to be done, Agnihotra, when should it be done? It should be done udite, after udite sati, surye udite sati. Once the Surya comes up, that time you have to do Agnihotra. The other paksha option is what? Anudite juhoti. Your homa, Agnihotra homa, should be before the sunrise. So इमीडिएटली आफ्टर सनराइज और बिफोर द सनराइज. देर आर टू पक्षास. नाउ इफ यू से लुक एट दीज दोज हु फॉलो द संप्रदाय ऑफ उदिते ज्योति एंड दोज हु फॉलो द संप्रदाय ऑफ अनुदिते ज्योति दे विल डू निंदा ऑफ द अदर्स. So the ninda is not the tatparya vishay. If you say that both cases are right, they are doing ninda of each other, then both should be discarded. For example, there are some people who say, those who know they know, those who do not know is okay, I don't want to name anyone. But then you have heard this, Bhamati and Vivarna have opposition to each other. There is Ninda. There are even, I think, cases discussed in some tikas where somebody is called as a dog or something. All these are should not be done, but these are human nature. Tatparya isn't there. When there is Krodha, they'll insult each other. In fact, if you look at those who say that no, Shankara Bhashya is only Pramana, the tikas are not Pramana, Bhamati and Vivarna, they are at each other's neck. What are they getting at? They say that you should not follow Vivarna, you should not follow Bhamati. So I'll take this opportunity, a deviation, to mention this. It is not a fact. So they say Shuddha Shankara Prakriya. There is nothing called a Shuddha Shankara Prakriya. Every Prakriya is Shuddha Shankara Prakriya. Bhamati is Shuddha Shankara Prakriya. Vivarna is Shuddha Shankara Prakriya. Asmadacharya Paryantam is Shuddha Shankara Prakriya because it is handed over in the Sampradaya. It is not opposed to the core Siddhanta. It answers the questions of particular people. You cannot say Drishti Srishti Vada is bogus, Srishti Drishti Vada is bogus. It answers a set of problems which are real for a set of sadhakas. So one who is sitting outside saying that Shankara Bhashya I'll parrot, that will not give anything. And there is dvesha towards Vivarnakaras and towards Bhamatikaras or their works. That dvesha is not useful. By that dvesha you are establishing that no, you know, my acharya is great. That does not work. Ninda of other acharyas and ninda of other works is only, it should not be done, but if at all it is there, it is of the work in a particular context, there is a ninda done, that it is not right. So it's a critical view, it is a critique. Being a critique and being insulting to others are two different things. You should look at what is the tatparya. Those who have not studied tarka, how to do the tatparya linga analysis in each Upanishad, etc., they can't understand this, unfortunately. So what happens is that if you say both are, Vivarna is doing ninda of Bhamati, Bhamati is doing ninda of Vivarna, then both should be discarded. You should stay with the Bhashya. This is what they start with and they end with that. That is their focus there. Now if you look at this, Udite Juhoti, Anudite Juhoti, what will happen? If you take both nindas together, you will say that you should drop the Homa itself, you should not do Agnihotra. That will be the resultant which is useless. It is actually, you have landed on something that you were better off doing anything than doing nothing. So, tatra anudita homa prasange udita homo nindyate, udita homa prasange cha anudita homaha nindyate. Tatra yadi nindayaha agnihotrantar parityage tatparyam syat tarhi kaladvaya api agnihotra parityaga prasanga eva syat. So what would happen is that at both times you will have to give up, because Udite, once the, you say that, oh, should I do the Agnihotra before Suryodaya? The Anudite Paksha says that, before that, Anudite may say yes, but then it does Ninda of Udite Juhoti. So Anudite Juhoti says that, before sunrise should I do the Agnihotra? The Udite Juhoti says yes, but Anudite Juhoti does Ninda, therefore you have to do Parityaga of Agnihotra before Suryodaya. Then should you do it after Suryodaya? Anudite Juhoti says yes, that Paksha says yes, but then Udite Juhoti does Ninda of that, no, you should not do. Therefore you should not do, meaning there should be Parityaga of Agnihotra after Suryodaya, meaning you shouldn't do. Thereby, you should not do before sunrise and you should not do after sunrise. Complete sarva parityaga eva syat. Nahi nityasya karmana parityaga sambhavati. You cannot give up nitya karma. It will give pratyavaya dosha. तस्माद् उदित होमस्तुतये अनुदित होम निंदा अनुदित होमस्तुतये चोदित होम निंदा क्रियते। एवमेव एक देवता उपासना प्रसंगे देवतानंतर निंदाया तात्पर्यं प्रकृत उपास्य देवता स्तुताओ एव न देवतानंतर निंदायाम। सो देयर इज नो तात्पर्य इन निंदा, इट इज ओनली इन द स्तुति ऑफ द पक्षा, एंड दैट विच एवर पक्षा यू होल्ड ऑन टू यू शुड डू द उपासना ऑफ दैट डीटी एज ईश्वर। यू नीड नॉट होल्ड ऑन टू वन, यू कैन डू उपासना ऑफ एनी डीटी on various days also as Ishvara, not an issue there. Pancha Devata Upasanayaha phalam ekam eva brahmalokaha. What is the phala of this upasana? Not upasana of any upasana of any devata in any role, but upasana of any devata in the form of Ishvara as Karana Brahma, Jagat Karana, will give only single result. What result? Brahmaloka is the result. How so? All the five devatas upasana will lead to single Brahmaloka as well. Shukla Krishna Yajush Shakha Bhedena Kechana Anuita Homan Kuruvanti Kechana Udita Homancha Ubheshancha Phalam Samanam Eva. Whether you do upasana based on Shakha Bheda Vedas, whether you do Agnihotra Nitya Karma before Suryodaya or after Suryodaya, both lead to the same goal. If you study that particular Shakha, your own Shakha, Swashakha, then you know that it leads to that goal. Then you pick up the other Shakha, not your Shakha, Parashakha, and study that, you know that it also leads to the same goal. Vedas are not lying there. So they say whichever you pick, it is going to lead to the same role, same goal. तथा इच्छा भेदवशात् पञ्चसोपि देवतासु यस्या कस्यचित् उपासनायां क्रियमाणायां पञ्चभिर् उपासनाभिर् ब्रह्मलोके एव प्राप्यते। नाउ इफ यू स्टडी दीज उपासनास आल्सो डिस्कस्ड इन वेरियस पुराणास, दे आर टू बी फॉलोड बेस्ड ऑन योर इच्छा। देयर इज एन इष्ट देवता बाय इच्छा, इष्ट इज the resultant of that Ichha, the object of that Ichha. So the object of that Ichha is the Ishta Devata. Based on that, you study that particular Purana, you see the goal is Brahmaloka, then you pick up the others and see that the goal there is also Brahmaloka. Tatrapi Brahmaloka eva prapyate. Tatratya bhoganubhavanantaram videha moksha siddhyati. And then what happens after that? Brahmaloka bhoga, there is videha moksha, videha mukti, because Brahmaloka, in Brahmaloka, Brahma himself is the teacher there. Through jnana there is moksha, but then the prarabdha ends when the Brahma's prarabdha ends. That particular Brahma, Chaturmukha Brahma's prarabdha ends, then Brahmaloka is resolved, there is pralaya. That time they get videha moksha, everyone there, more or less everyone there has apunaravrtihi, meaning they will not have janma, they will get videha muktihi. Yadyapi vishnuadi devata upasanaya vaikunthadi loka eva prapyate iti puraneshu uchyate natu brahmaloka, tathapi videha mukti adhikaritvad uttama upasakaha devayana margena brahmalokam eva gacchanti. Although Vishnu Purana will talk about Vaikuntha, the real result is brahmaloka if that Vishnu is seen as Ishvara. What kind of Ishvara? The Jagat Karana. Jagat Karana Ishvara. Thereby they will get brahmaloka, not Vaikuntha Loka. Vaikuntha Loka is the appearance of Brahmaloka to the Vishnu Upasaka. Similarly, Kailasa is the appearance of the same Brahmaloka to the Shiva Upasaka. So this is the topic next as to Ekaiva Brahmaloka Vishnu Upasakasya Vaikuntha Rupena Bhati Tatratya Sarvepi Chaturbhujayava Lakshante. So since he has done Vishnu Upasana, Vishnu as Ishvara, this Upasaka is seeing Chaturbhuja Vishnu in his Upasana and says that, oh, you are the, meaning has vritti as you are the Jagat Karana Brahma, So he is used to seeing Chaturbhuja, four hands. Therefore, he sees everyone there as having four hands, including himself, in the Vaikuntha Loka, which is really Brahma Loka. In his view, it is all Vaikuntha Loka. Although he is in Brahma Loka, so it is the it's like a multiverse, you know. It's in the same place, you have a different level of a different perspective based on your upasana. That is the phala. Swayam api chaturbhuja bhavati shiva upasakasya shivalokatvena bhati tatratya sarve trinetra dharinaha pratiyante swayam upasaka api tathayo bhavati. Whereas the shiva upasaka who is seeing this trinetri shiva will see Brahmaloka as having, you know, this Kailasa Vasa. He'll see that this phala is Kailasa. Although reaching the same Brahmaloka, he'll see everyone as having three netras, not chaturbhujas. He'll see everyone as having three netras, including himself. So he also becomes Trinetri. Evameva sarvesha api tattad upasakanam एक एव ब्रह्मलोकः तत्तद् उपास्य लोकात्मना प्रतीयते. सो देयर इज अ प्रतीति, जस्ट लाइक हियर देयर इज अ प्रतीति, देयर इज अ ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड सब्जेक्टिव प्रतीति. सिमिलरली देयर आल्सो देयर इज अ प्रतीति टू द उपासक बेस्ड ऑन द उपासना दैट ही हैज फॉलोड. यथा यथा श्रुतम, सो यथा यथा विधि यथा श्रुतम. सो देयर इज अ यथादृष्टम यथाश्रुतम, देयर इज अ आई फॉरगेट द एग्जैक्ट फ्रेज, बट देन भगवान भाष्यकार सेज दैट फला इज बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट यू हैव हर्ड एंड व्हाट यू यथाकृतम, आई थिंक. सो यथाकर्म यथाकर्म यथाश्रुतम, सो बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट कर्म हैज वन डन एंड व्हाट वन हैज हर्ड अबाउट, बेस्ड ऑन दैट देयर इज अ रिजल्ट. सो दिस पर्सन हैज डन द उपासना, ही हैज डन मानस कर्म ऑफ उपासना. सो यथा कर्म यथा उपासना, सिमिलरली इज हिज यथाश्रुतम. हाउ हैज ही हर्ड इन द पुराणास, ही हैज हर्ड शिवा एज हैविंग थ्री नेत्रास, सो दैट विल बी द फला इन द सेम ब्रह्मलोक. वैष्णव हैज डन उपासना, ही इज मानस कर्म, सो यथा कर्म. व्हाट इज द फला? यथाश्रुत, ही हैज हर्ड दैट देयर आर चतुर्भुज, विष्णु इज चतुर्भुज एंड देन वैकुंठ ही हैज चतुर्भुज पीपल उपासक, सो ही इज co-vasis, everyone who stays with him, they will all be what sahavasis will be, chaturbhujas, including himself. So atrayam niyamah. So anyway, there is a marga discussed. We'll come back to the moola since it flips across pages. Let's finish the tippana. So devayana pitru, there is a devayana discussed as leading to what? As leading to here itself, devayana marga. It was mentioned earlier also. So there is a marga with which the upasaka goes to a particular loka, that is discussed. Or a karmi or an upasaka, one who mixes it up, they have different lokas based on, again, same yatha karma yatha shrutam. So devayana pitruyana jayasu mriyasu iti trividhaha samsara margaha. So one marga is devayana, the other marga is pitruyana, taking to pitru loka. Devayana is taking to devaloka. Which devaloka? विष्णु लोक कैलास वैकुंठ लोक कैलास इत्यादि दे और सूर्य मंडल इत्यादि दे आर ऑल ब्रह्म लोक दिस इज द तात्पर्य विषय पितृयान विल टेक यू टू पितृलोक जायस्व मृयस्व मीन्स दैट वेर वन विल कंटिन्यू इन संसार त्रिविधा संसार मार्ग दीज आर ऑल्सो संसार मार्ग देवयान बेस्ड ऑन वॉट कैंड ऑफ उपासना वन विल बी बॉर्न अगेन वन मे नॉट बी बॉर्न अगेन Pitruloka, definitely one will be born again. Jayasya Mriyasya means he may not even go to other lokas, he'll continuously be born in this loka itself. With a very short gap. Surya Mandalam Bhitva, Brahma Loka Gamana Margaha, Devayanaha, Pantaha, Archiradi Marga iti Chauchyate. So this Deva Marga is called as the Surya Mandala. It is in Surya Mandala. So breaking through the Surya, the orb of the Surya, one enters the Surya Loka, which is really Brahma Loka, that is the Devayana, also called as what? Archiradi Marga, Brahma Loka Gamana Marga. All these have the same meaning. Chandra Mandalam Bhitva, whereas breaking through the orb of Chandra, Indraloka Gamana Margaha, one that leads to Indraloka, or called as what? Pitriyana Margaha, Dhumadi Marga, these are all having the same meaning. Iti cha uchyate, punaf punar janana maranadi, pravaha karani bhuta mrityuloka gamana margaha, jayasvamriyasveti, tritiya kashto margaha. Whereas the third is what? Mrityuloka gamana marga. One dies and comes back in another garbha. Kashta marga, this is the difficulty. Samsara is real to that person. Never goes away. Dukkha is real. Whereas the others enjoy much longer, multiple times of this lifetime, they have sukha, whether they go to Pitriloka or go to Brahmaloka or Vaikuntha ityadi, Swarga ityadi. They come back, but then they have a lot of sukha before they come back. Turiyo marga, Turiyaha moksha margas to Brahma Jnanatmaka eva. The other marga is not discussed, which is the fourth marga, Turiya, which is Jnanena Mokshaha, Jivan Mukti itself. Back to Mula, Atrayam Niyamaha. What is the rule there? Devayana Margam Vina, Margantarana Ganta Punah Punah Samsaram Eva Gacchati. The Niyama, as per the Vedas, is what? One who goes through Devayana Marga, Surya Mandalam Vitva, goes to Brahmaloka and there is apunaravruttihi. So other than Devayana Marga, one who goes through any other marga, that Ganta, Gantru, Punah Punah Samsarameva Gacchati, would come back to Samsara again and again. Brahmaloka Gamana Margastu Devayana Akhya Eka Eva. Brahmaloka Gamana Marga is the same which is called as Devayana. Tasmat videha mukti yogya upasakaha sarvepi brahmalokam gacchanti. So those who are fit for videha mukti based on their own upasana, as what? With the understanding that the deity is Ishvara, who is all pervasive jagat karana, has appeared as the entire karya, then that upasana will lead to brahmaloka and they are fit for videha mukti. तादृशे ब्रह्मलोके उपासके इच्छानुसारेण सकल सामग्री विशिष्ट तत्तल्लोकात्मना प्रतीयमानत्व रूपः अद्भुत महिमा वर्तते एवं पंचदेवता उपासनाय फलम एकमेव. सो दे रीच ब्रह्मलोक दे हैव व्हाट सकल सामग्री विशिष्ट तत्तल्लोकात्मना प्रतीयमानत्व रूपः दे हैव डिफरेंट एक्सपीरियंसेस बेस्ड ऑन देयर उपासनास. In the same Brahmaloka, Adbhuta Mahima Vartate, it is a great wonder, and this is true with any of these five devatas in the Panchayatana Puja, whatever we follow. So, the result is same Brahmaloka. Ekasmin Neva Paramatmani, the next avarta, Ekasmin Neva Paramatmani, Nana Nama Rupa Pratiti Sambhavana. So there is a question anyway, I was thinking that this upasana leads to videha mukti directly without jivan mukti. There may be some idea there. I mentioned this, that jnanena moksha, but still, even if they don't get jnana in the brahmaloka, which is generally talked about, still they can get videha mukti. How so? Because see, what has been said is there, videha mukti yogyaha upasaka. How does one become yogyaha for videha mukti? Even by upasana it is possible, but that upasana is based on jnana here and now. Which is this jnana? That is why some people think that, oh, I have to study Upanishads. It's not true. Look at the elaborate details that we have seen in Vichara Sagara. Even if you study multiple Upanishads, it is not easy to put together these ideas. Each Upanishad has the capacity to lead the sadhaka to mukti. But sadhaka should have that capacity. Otherwise, Upanishads are very difficult. They are very cryptic. Here, we see in Prakarana Granthas or in Puranas also, it is very easy to grasp. A person studies one Purana, say Vishnu Purana or Shiva Purana, Skanda Purana, you see that your deity is praised, the stuti is that he is Ishvara, she is Ishvara. whichever deity it is. Then you hold on to that description of Ishvara and do upasana on that Ishvara is discussed as Jagat Karana, who appears in the form of anything and everything. Every Shakti is his Shakti, her Shakti, however you see it. There is no Linga Bheda to be done there, therefore the same Brahma is discussed. So when you are doing the upasana, you are not doing Dvaita Upasana, you are doing Advaita Upasana. If that takes place, then the person is Videha Mukti Yogya. Thereby one attains Brahmaloka and there is Apunaravruti. So Jnana is there, which is not complete here, but through Upasana you are holding on to that Tatparya Vishaya of Advaita itself. Therefore, one is Videha Mukti Yogya, although not Jivan Mukti Yogya here and now. So that is the idea one has to hold on to, otherwise there will be thinking that, oh, Upasana will lead to Moksha, why should I go through any other this thing? But Upasana itself is difficult. So Chanchalantu Manakrishnaha, says Arjuna, and then Krishna agrees. So it is what? Vayuvat Adridam. So it is very difficult to hold on to the manas. So Upasana, you know that it is difficult anyway. Ekasminyo Paramatmani Nana Nama Rupa Pratiti Sambhavana. The same Paramatma appears in different ways and is discussed in different ways in each Purana. It is a possibility. How so? So there is no contradiction there at all. When Vyasacharya discusses same Ishvara as Vishnu, Shiva, Devi, Ganesha, Surya in various Upanishads, various Puranas, Upapuranas. Nanu, Panchana Videvana Namarupadeha Vibhinna Kathyante Ishvarastu Eka Eva. So all these Pancha Devatas are different from each other, whereas the name is different, the form is different, whereas Ishvara is one. How do you say all are Ishvara? Kathan vidam ekasyeva nana nama rupatvadi sambhavet iti chet atra abhidiyate. What is the idea there? Paramarthatana kinchidapi nama rupadikam paramatmani yujyate. Brahma paramatma has no name and form. Athapi mandabuddhinam upasanartham nama ruparahite eva paramatmani nama rupadikam kalpanikam eva upeyate. So upaya is being used for mandabuddhis who it is very, very difficult, so much so that it is almost next to impossible if you try to do nirguna upasana. What object do you have? You have no object to hold on to. No shabda, no rupa, no rasa, no gandha, no sparsha to hold on to. What will you hold on to? Thereby, many ways there is a discussion giving names and forms. Somehow you hold on to this Ishvara. Therefore, guna walks in. Once guna walks in, then you have got saguna, you have got nama rupa. Thereby, the same Ishvara can be talked about in various ways with various names and forms without changing the Ishvaratvam of Ishvara. So, nama rupa kalpana is done as an upaya to help the upasaka not to do ninda, not saying that it is impossible to have various forms. All forms are to help the upasaka reach the goal. The same goal that the other upasaka with other name and form intends to reach. Tasmat kalpanikam upayate. Tasmat ekasminyo paramatmani maya kalpitam namarupadikam nanavidam sambhavatyeva. So names and forms with their varieties and contradictions are possible in the uncontradicted nama rupa rahita brahma paramatma. Itham hi sarva purana vakyanam virodha api nivartate. There is no virodha is understood even across puranas by one who has this understanding. The next avartas is sarveshavi purananam karyakarana brahmopasana bodhana kramavashad Heopadeya Vishekatva Tatparya Nirupanam. So all Purana, Sarveshavi Purana Nam Karekarana Brahma Upasana Bodhana Kramavashad. सिंस दे आर शोइंग दिस कार्य कारण रिलेशन एंड दे शो दैट ईच ऑफ दीज डीटी कैन बी सीन एज कार्य ऑल्सो एंड कारण ऑल्सो एंड थ्रू दैट क्रम यू कैन सी विच इज हेय विच इज उपादेय which in the krama when you see karya brahma and karana brahma same deity then across puranas then what happens you know which is here which is upade which should be given up which should be taken up which name and form is upasya which name and form is not upasya the same name with a particular form is upasya in a particular role and in particular role not upasya meaning what we have seen this every name and form is upasya as ishvara every name and form is not upasya as non ishvara in a subsidiary role this is the idea purana vakyanam paraspara viruddha vidhayakatva shankaya mukhyam samadhanam what is the way to settle this once and for all shiva vishnu ganesha devi suryadikam na pratyekam karana brahma bodakam all these names shiva vishnu ganesha devi or surya or other names are also used they are really each of these are really revealing the karana brahma itself कार्यब्रह्मणामपि समानम् एव एतन्नाम जातम् हाउएवर द सेम नेम शिवा विष्णु गणेश देवी सूर्य एटसेट्रा दीज आर यूज्ड फॉर कार्यब्रह्म आल्सो सो वी शुड नॉट गेट कंफ्यूज इन व्हाट उपासना शुड आई डू आई शुड डू उपासना ऑफ एनी ऑफ दीज एज कारण ब्रह्म नॉट एज कार्य माया विशिष्टम चैतन्यम कारणम ब्रह्म इति कथयन्ति सो व्हाट इज कारण ब्रह्म माया विशिष्ट ब्रह्म Same Nirguna Brahma who takes Maya as Upadhi is Upasya with the name as Shiva, Vishnu, Ganesha, Devi or Surya or whatever have you. Karyabhutam Hiranyagarbham api Brahma iti vadanti. Hiranyagarbha is also called as Brahma. Why? Because same Ishvara, when he becomes Samashti Sukshma Sharirabhimani, he is called as Hiranyagarbha. The same Ishvara when he is seen as this समष्टि स्थूल शरीर अभिमानी ही इज कॉल्ड एज विराट सो द उपासना इज टू बी ऑफ द ऑफ ईश्वरा नॉट ऑफ एज हिरण्यगर्भ इन अ लिमिटेड रोल ऑफ इवन इफ इट इज एसोसिएटेड विद समष्टि ही इज एसोसिएटेड विद समष्टि सूक्ष्म शरीर सो दैट एसोसिएशन इज नॉट हेल्पफुल It is missing the Stula Sharira association. It is also missing the Ishwarattvam, which is without the Upadhis. Thereby, Ishwara is Upasya, non-Ishwara or limited role, however great, is not Upasya. Ittham Karanam Brahma, Karyam Brahma Chaiti, Ubhayavidham Api Brahma Vishnu Shivadaya Shabda Bodhayanti. So, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, all these are... are the same names used for karana also and for karya also tatha eva etesham panchara api devanam narayana neelakantha vignesha shakti bhanu ityadini api anantani paryaya padani vidyante so you look up amarakosha or you look up any dictionary vachaspati kalpadruma if you vachaspatyam kalpadruma if you look at these shabdakoshas What do you see? Vishnu is called as Narayana. Shiva is called as Neelakantha. Ganesha is called as Vignesha. Devi is called as Shakti. Surya is called as Bhanu. And there are other names also. Paryaya Shabdas are many. So the same name, Shiva is used for Karya Brahma also, Karana Brahma also. Vishnu is used for Karya Brahma also, Karana Brahma also, ityadi. Whereas the same Karana and Karya Brahma can also be called not only as Shiva but also as Neelakantha not only as Vishnu but also as Narayana ityadi not only as Devi also as Shakti ityadi so there are so many names used for the same deity in the karya role also karana role also and there are many names used of other deities also in the Karana rule also, Karya rule also. Therefore, whichever name you pick of whichever deity, you should hold on to Karana Brahma. Tani api Karana Karyatmakam, Ubhaya Rupam api Brahma Bodhayanti, Kvachit Karanam Brahma, Kvachit Chakaryam Brahma, Prasanganusarana Bodhayanti. So it is all contextual in the Purana. यथा सैंधव शब्द अश्व लवण लवण उभय बोधकोपि भोजन प्रकरणे लवणम गमन प्रकरणे अश्वंच बोधयति एवम्. So an example is given to drive home the point as to why should you pick only one, how can the same name or different names mean the same thing, how can different names mean the same thing, how can the same name mean different things. So here the example is used to show that how the same name can be used for different things and what should you hold on to. You should hold on to Karana, not Karya. For that the example is not Saindava. So Saindava Shabda is used. What is Saindava? What is Sindhu Desha related, that is called as Saindava. So Sindhu Sambandhi Saindava, that is the Taddita Vritti, the simplest one. Sindhu Sambandhi Saindava. तद्धितेषु च अचामादेहे वृद्धिः. सो वृद्धिर् भवति, देयर इज अ सिंधु हैज इकार हैज टेकन वृद्धि. व्हाय? तद्धितेषु अचाम आदेहे, आदे अचाम वृद्धि भवति. सो द फर्स्ट अच, फर्स्ट स्वरा, फर्स्ट वोवेल विल टेक वृद्धि. सो ई हैज बिकम ऐ. सो सिंधु हैज बिकम सैंधव. देन देयर इज अ संधि, उ हैज बिकम अव देयर. So Saindhava, when Saindhava said something related to Sindhu, it can mean anything. But then what are the known meanings, Rudi Artha of Saindhava? It can be Ashwa also, it can mean a horse, Saindhava. So famous, the Saindhava Desha horse is Ashwa, is very famous, used to be famous, so Puraneshu. And today also what do we know? We know Saindhava Lavana. So we know Lavana the salt, which is Saindhava, called as Saindhava. For whatever reasons, we may not know the history of it. It may not be literal also. It may be the origin also in Sindhu Desha, have origin. So Saindhava Lavana va Saindhava Ashwa va? Saindhava Lavanam va Saindhava Ashwa va? When somebody says Saindhavam Anaya, are you going to bring salt or are you going to bring a horse? So bhojana prakarani, if somebody is sitting for bhojana and says saindhava anaya, obviously one is not going to bring a horse. You have to be out of your wits to bring a horse, you will bring salt. So there is no confusion there. How can there be confusion? So the question is ridiculed. How can you even ask as to who is Upasya? Karana is Upasya, Tatparya Vishaya is Upasya, Atatparya Vishaya, Tatparyasya Avishaya is not Upasya. How can even such a question arise? Will you ask while sitting for Bhojana, Saindhava Manaya means should I bring an Ashwa or not? So when you are sitting for Upasana, you should not ask whether the Karya Brahma is Upasya. It is not. Karana Brahma is Upasya. Similarly, Gamana Prakarane, when you are, you know, on the battlefield or, you know, you are going somewhere, you know, old age. That time, you say, okay, you tell the guy, you know, somebody is assisting you or your friend or whatever relative, you say, Saindhava Manaya. So, if he brings salt, what's going to happen? So, you don't expect that also. You expect that the horse has to be brought. Therefore, you'll bring a horse. It is all contextual. So what has been seen? That the same name can be used for Karya and Karana also. And different names can also be used for the same deity as Karana or Karya. Who is Upasya? Karana. Karana Brahma, not Karya. So anyway, too much said. Vaishnavadi Granthastha Vishnuadi Stuti Shivadi Ninda Vachananam Vyasa Viprayastvayameva. What is the Abhipraya of Vyasa there? What is the idea when, you know, what was he thinking? People will say, what was Vyasacharya thinking? I mean, you are creating many Puranas yourself. Why would you do Ninda of the same deities that you praise in other Puranas. What was the idea? What were you thinking? What were you thinking is insulting. But what was the idea is Shodha, Shodhana Kriya. You purify your thinking and then you understand what he was thinking. Otherwise, we can't think. So, Vyasabhiprayastu evameva karanam brahma upasyam karyam tu brahma na upasyam iti. We have seen many times. Tatra Vaishnaveshu Puraneshu Vishnu Narayanadi Shabda karanam brahma bodhayanti Shiva Ganesha Shakti Suryadi Shabdastu tatratya karyam eva brahma pakrushtam eva manyatrapi. So, in Vishnu Purana, Vishnu Stuti Dwara, Vishnu is shown as Ishvara because he is seen as Karana Brahma. He is Upasya as Karana Brahma. Whereas all other deities are shown as Karya Brahma. They are not Upasya. Meaning, as Karya Brahma, they are not Upasya. Whereas you go to other Puranas. So, we'll just go through this. Skanda Purana Adi Shaiva Granteshu Shiva Mahesha Adi Shabda Karanam Brahma Bodhayanti Vishnu Ganesha Devi Surya Adi Shabdastu Karyam Brahma Ganesha Purana Api Ganesha Padam Karanasya Brahmanah Vishnu Shiva Adi Padani Karyasya Brahmanascha Vachakani Kali Devi Purane Kali Devi Adi Shabda Karanam Brahma Vishnu Shiva Surya Adi Shabda Karyam Brahma Cha Bodhayanti Saura Purane Cha Bhanu Surya Adeha शब्दाः कारणस्य ब्रह्मणः शिवादि शब्दाः कार्यस्य ब्रह्मणस्य बोधकाः तस्मात् सर्वत्र कारणस्तुतिः कार्यनिन्दा च उपपन्ना एव. सो अक्रॉस उपनिषद्स अक्रॉस पुराणास व्हिचएवर इज द मेन डीटी दैट डीटी स्तुति इज डन एज ईश्वर ही और शी इज उपास्य एंड ऑल अदर डीटीज आर शोन एज कार्य ब्रह्म दे आर नॉट उपास्य मीनिंग As Karya Brahma, they are not Upasya. If you take their respective titled Puranas, you will see they are not Karya Brahma at all. They are Karana Brahma, shown as Karya Brahma in other Puranas. Evam Nikhileshu Puraneshu Karya Karana Sanya Rupanam Sanketanam Yobhedaha Natu Heopade Rupe Vivakshite Arthe. So, Tatpare is not as Heya, but Karya is Heya, Karana is not, Karana is Upadeya, Karana Brahma Upasana should be done with any name and form. Sarva Puraneshu Karana Brahma Upasana Upadeya, Karya Brahma Upasana cha Heya. Tasma Sarva Purana Ravi Ekam Karanam Eva Brahma Upasyam Mityatre Vatatpuryam Natesham Swarthe Virodha. There is no Virodha. In fact, there is Samanvaya if you understand everything with the bird's eye view. You will get the bird's eye view only when you have the worm's view, you know, when you have that view of the, in detail, when you study all Puranas, then alone you will see the complete picture. So people say, look at the complete picture, does not mean a bird's eye view, no, just a overview. The overview is possible. One, who can give a sankshep of all Puranas in proper measure? Only one who has studied all Puranas in detail. So thereby, Samanvaya is that every name and form which is seen as in Puranas discussed as Ishvara, Karana Brahma is Upasya, whereas same names as Karya Brahma are not Upasya. So we'll look at the 525th Avarta in the next part. सुख नित्यं सुख प्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपं अधिष्ठानं बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धिर्लोक्यतेन पारं सर्व वेदान्तमेव तदेव अन्वक्तुं निमिष्यतामिति ॐ तत्सत् नमस्ते सॉरी